47-year-old taxi driver Moses Bertrand had been a taxi driver for some 20 years and says what happened to him this week is something he had never experienced or expected. He said, ironically, it was not his turn to transport visitors, but when the driver next in line had to go to the bank on business, he was summoned by a member of staff of Capella Resorts in Marigot to transport a visiting couple to the George F.L. Charles Airport to catch a morning flight. Shortly after the couple boarded his minibus, sitting behind in the passenger seats, Bertrand says the trouble started.
While I leave the hotel I drive in, I hear the man start crying. So he crying the whole way until I reach Lakwa. When I reach Lakwa, he asks me, going down the hill, he asks me, how you doing? Everything okay? I say, everything fine. I say, what about you? He said, everything fine, everything okay. And that's it. He never tell me nothing. So when I drive, call this sack, when I swing to the tunnel road, while I drive in, I just see the man just come from, I just feel the man come from behind and just rush on me.
Bertrand says while under attack, he was trying to defend himself, unlock his seatbelt and control his vehicle at the same time.
I don't know how the van managed to stop, but while I stop, how many drivers stop one time and I try and do defense. When I get out, managed to get out from the van, all myself had cut already.
What was he using to cut you?
Honestly, I don't see what he had because I was trying to defense because I know I seen blood, you know. Honestly, I don't know what he had.
Bertrand recalled managing eventually to stop the vehicle and said that other motorists who had seen his vehicle moving erratically on the road came to his assistance. He remembered that there happened to be a police officer on the scene, but could not recount other details except that the officer helped to stop the bleeding and ensured that he was taken to hospital. But what became of his attacker?
I believe he's in custody or yesterday when I leave the hospital around minutes to four, he was at the hospital. Yeah.
Which hospital?
Victoria Hospital. It was just casualty. Yeah.
Was he injured?
Well, I understand they had him before to the hospital. He was some station in Castries. He tried and jump a window. So they had to take him to the hospital.
Bertrand, who lives with an aging father who depends on him for financial support, says his injuries are affecting his livelihood and he does not know when he will be able to go back to work. For the DBS News World, Alex Bousquet reporting.